Oliver and I were having dinner in late 2007 and talking about history and politics, as we often do. And he said to me, Peter, let's do it. Let's really do it. Let's do a documentary. And we figured we were going to do a 60 or 90 minute documentary about the origins of the Cold War and Henry Wallace and the atomic bombings of 1945. And then I went up to see him in New York a couple weeks later. And by then, it had turned from one 60-minute documentary into a 10-part, 10-hour documentary film series. We didn't have an outlet yet. We started working on it with the assumption that we'd get it aired somewhere. And so initially, I thought it was going to take 6 months or 9 months, a year at most. We ended up working on this for 5 years. We wrote this for 5 years. And we ended up writing 12 episodes and producing 12 episodes, 10 of which showed on Showtime. But about halfway to two-thirds of the way through this project, we decided, well, we have to add a book. Because what we wanted to say, what you can say in 58 minutes, 30 seconds, is very limited. We wanted to say a lot. So it's very dense. Some people have said it's the most dense documentary they've ever seen, but it's still not nearly what we wanted to say. So then we added an 800-page book to this. So this was 5 years of nonstop collaboration. Oliver, during that time, made two other movies. I co-authored two other books, but it was very, very intensive. So we worked very closely together, to the point where the Washington Times interviewer, who interviewed us after it just aired in 2012 or early 2013, said that we're like an old married couple and we complete each other's sentences. So it got that close, that kind of collaboration. What's it like working with Oliver? He's exacting. He can be difficult. He's very demanding. He's tireless. He works, I worked around the clock nonstop for 5 years. He did the same thing. And he's a perfectionist. What he brings is a vision, and he brings the ability to make something very dramatic. So when the first time I would see what he would do with my words and then his words who went back and forth and back and forth on the scripts, and the way he could bring that to life with his narration, with the visuals, with the music, and with the content, to me was staggering. I still can watch them over and over and over again without ever getting bored, because I find them to be as dramatic as a feature film. So what we brought together was my abilities as a historian, Oliver's interests as an amateur historian, and Oliver's skills as one of the world's leading filmmakers. Well, they're all my children. So you don't like to choose among your children. I would say that the one I'm closest to in some ways is episode 3 about the atomic bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. I direct the Nuclear Studies Institute. I take students to Hiroshima and Nagasaki every summer for the last 19 years. So that's very, very close to me. And that's what I mostly had been writing about and working on before that. But they all this episode tonight, the Obama Bush episode, is to me extraordinarily powerful. And that's really what we began with. The issue was, how did we get to this place in 2008 where George Bush was president, where the United States were invading the two countries, where we were ripping up the Constitution, where this militarist mindset had really taken hold in America, surveillance, targeted assassinations, massive warfare. What had happened to our country? And we wanted to just not look at it the narrow way, saying Bush is the bad guy, which he is, but we wanted to go back and trace the origins of this. We wanted to see this as part of a pattern that had been developing at least since the 1890s in the United States. We wanted to give people historical perspective so they wouldn't see this policy as aberrant, but we'd see it as consistent with these long flows of history that have been occurring over a century, more than a century.